French embassy to Fulham Cemetery.
What?
What do you mean, what?
French where?
Embassy.
Oh! Which cemetery?
You idle sod, you haven't learned it.
hang about, I know it.
Oh, yeah.
Said last night. Got it nearly word perfect.
Page 10, right, run number 8.
Hang about.
Leaving right Albert Gate, left Carriage Road, left Alexander Gate, Ford Exhibition Road, right Thurlow Street, comply South Kensington Junction, leave by Old Brompton Road.
Oh, the French Embassy! Oh.
Well, ask them.
I don't know.
Well, if you want to know,
don't.
Excuse me.
Knowledge, boys.
What?
On a knowledge. Those sods.
It's incorrect. And then forward, where'd you call it? Right, Fulham Palace Road.
Left, you number. And you missed out Lily Bridge and Lily Road.
What's the knowledge then?
It's all right, I know.
It's a form of euthanasia.
What do I have to do?
You're not mental as far as I can see. If you've got a death wish, I believe that can help.
Hey, tell you what. Try me on Woburn Square to Northern Polytechnic instead.
What the hell for?
I know that one. Clifford.
Dog, it's your mother what asks you the ones you know. Them sadists up the road ask you the ones you don't.
That's how they become sadists in the first place. Know what I mean?
Excuse me. This knowledge, how'd you get on here?
The Metropolitan Police Public Carriage Office. Across the road, it's 20, 25 yards down on your left.
22.
Hang on, we don't know what it entails or nothing. Well, I mean, it'll entail things, won't it?
Blood, sweat and tears, that's all.
Right, that's it.
What's what? Don't know what the hell you're going
tempting,
on.
Tempting, innit?
What is?
Have a bit of apple pie.
No, thanks. Look, I just want to know what you're getting.
Go on, half inch.
What are you all worked up about?
So that was it, how it all started. I applied to go on the knowledge, and I didn't even know what it was. I found out, though. By hell, I found out.
You go to umpteen colleges till your brain goes soft and flabby, but won't know what the knowledge is until you're a London cabbie. Every street and square and lane, everywhere from A to Z. Go bonkers, barmy, go insane, and while you're at it, off your head.
That's the knowledge, bad you grin. That's the knowledge.
Know what I mean?
Photos.
Right.
Six copies.
Thank you very
right.
Much.
Yes.
Apply for the knowledge.
That's right. Driving license.
First certificate.
All go, innit?
That's your application form. You fill that in. That's your medical form. Your doctor fills that in. And that's your slip for the photographer in Upper Street. Your photos, six copies.
Yeah, I've already got a photo.
It has to be the six official photos from Upper Street. Plan for the knowledge.
Me? No, I've done the applying.
Fair enough.
Already.
Yeah, okay.
I'm here for my acceptance interview to, you know, go on it sort of thing.
Room 12.
What's this here?
Well, that's where you go.
Well, that's what I thought, isn't it, really? Which way is room 12?
Where are you going?
Oh, right. No problem. Right.
At the time I started on the knowledge, I was on the payroll of the biggest firm in England. The Department of Health and Social Security, on the dole. I've been out of work ever since I left school, nearly, with my 4 O-levels. That's the advantage of a good education. You learn how to write so as you can sign on, and how to read so as you can see what jobs you've no chance of ever getting.
Makes you laugh, doesn't it? Never sod in Neverland.
I get a bit sick of laughing. Makes your face ache. Is this the room 12 for starting the knowledge?
You are?
So it says room 12. Oh, I expect there's only the one.
No smoking, if you don't mind. Except in the case of expectant fathers, who shouldn't be here in the first place.
As soon as you're enjoying your bleeding self. Subject normal.
Now, if you cast your minds back a few months, you may have fond memories of filling these in. Your completed application forms, T-rings and all. So just sing out when I call your names. Now I'm going to put a face to each of you. Walters Kennington Oval.
Here.
If any of you wishes to call me sir, I shall try not to be offended. Staveley Dulwich.
Yes, sir.
Constantine Notting Hill.
Yes, sir.
O'Reilly Kilburn.
Here, sir.
Campion Kentish Town.
Yes, sir.
Matthew Stepney.
Sir.
Weller Gunnersbury Park.
Present and correct.
Margolis Kingsbury.
Yes, sir.
James Clapham.
Yes, sir.
Osborne Bellum.
Sir.
Terrific. You all know your own names. My living shall not be in vain. Now, my name is Mr. Burgess. No applause, please. And this little chat is known as your acceptance interview, which means that you are now, starting today, officially on the knowledge, which, by a remarkable twist of logic, brings us to question number one. Namely, what exactly is the knowledge?
Well, all it is really is boning up in your head all the macaroni about...
Thank you, Mr. Weller. That was known as a rhetorical question. I know what the knowledge is. In other words, I tell you. In other words, you keep your mouth shut and listen. You might learn something. Namely, what exactly is the knowledge?
I knew what it was, all right. The next greasy step on the treadmill. Like everything else, with a bunch of greens dangled in front of your rooter. Well, I'd tried everything else in my time, hadn't I? Gordon Weller, the cowboy of Wild West Free, cowboy plumber, then cowboy electrician, then cowboy carpenter, then since April, cowboy kitchen installer. And I made a right cow out of all of them. Three cocked-up kitchens later, I thought, hang up your boots, cowboy, let's find a cushier number, shall we? E.g., charging Arabs 15 quid for a taxi ride from London Airport.
God, you idiot!
It's all right, love. Do you know your floor's not level?
As laid down by the London Hackney Carriage Act of 1843, all the knowledge means is that you commit to memory every street within a 6-mile radius of Charing Cross, every street and what's on every street. Every hotel, every club, every hospital, every department store, every shop, government building, theatre, cinema, restaurant, park, art gallery, church, synagogue, mosque, etc., 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 and etc. Every building or amenity in public use, you name it, you've got to know it. Now, this is your Bible. It is called the Blue Book, probably why it's coloured pink. Now don't ask me why pink is called blue, bit like life in a way.
On page number one, you will find a list, what we call a page, of routes which we call runs. Now, run number one, page number one, is Manor House Station to Gibson Square. Manor House is the starting point, Gibson Square is the finishing point. Not that anybody has ever wanted to go from Manor House to Gibson Square, but you have to know how to. So far, piece of pudding. Except for one little thing. There's not one page, there's 26. Not one run on each page is 18. So that's 468 runs altogether. Which means that the amount of macaroni you have to bone up in your head, Mr. Weller, is a grand total of approximately 15,842 streets and the few thousand buildings on those streets. By heart. Now, don't blame me. Knowledge goes back 350 years, slightly before my time. It was started by decree of the Lord Protector, one Oliver Cromwell.
Trust that bastard have something to do with this.
In my case, the knowledge went back to the day I was born, into a family of cab drivers. As a kid, I thought all cars were black with only one seat in the front. Even now, Sunday afternoon at my house was like Oxford Street during the Kipper season. My granddad used to be a cabbie. My old man still was. And my father-in-law. And my two brothers. You were a Margolis, you were a cabbie, right? Except I wasn't, was I? I mean, granted, not even Val was exactly over the moon, me grafting at a laundry. I worked the Hoffman Press at the time. I mean, like she said, it's not skilled, but it's not rubbish. But my family reckon it was. Like I was breaking the Margolis tradition, like I'd married out or something. Val said I shall punch him in the mouth. I'm not a violent man. I come on the knowledge instead. To become the best Margolis that ever pushed a cab. Right? Better than a lot of them. A lot of them.
Now, if you think you can master the knowledge, sat in your own front parlour with your blue book in one hand and your girlfriend in the other, accepting your presence, Miss Staveley, watching Liverpool win 1-0 in the last 3 seconds of match of the day, thank you, good night, and God bless, because you can't. There are knowledge schools that will guide you. But the only way to learn the knowledge is by climbing onto your bike and doing the sod. Every single street of it. There is no other way. And I'll tell you a little secret. 7 out of the 10 of you sitting here today will never make it. Everybody happy?
Happy? Always have been, mate. I could write a bloody book on happiness. Cheapest book on the market. Bound to be. There'll be no bleeding pages in it.
Oi! Get your finger out, Noddy! Car's depreciating the wet.
I've been depreciating since I was born, mate. And I was worth sod all then.
Can't be a minute, sir.
Let me put him in his place. Happy at me work. Happy at home. Lillian did competitions. Spot the ball, place in order the best features of the latest Ford Fiesta, crosswords by the thousand. And she hadn't a clue. Never won nothing. And she reckoned I was a disaster. That's how I got my nickname, wasn't it? Titanic. She hadn't spoken to me since her honeymoon, 17 years previous. She never said why.
Now, just in case you're all having too good a time, one last thought. On page 2 of your forms, you answer the following 2 questions, which are deliberately in heavy black type. 11A. Have you ever been convicted of any offence or been bound over? 11B. Are you the subject of any outstanding charge or something? All of you answered no. All of you told the truth. Because we've checked. as we always continue to do right through your career as a cabbie. If you ever have one, that is. So, if your hobby is mugging old ladies, or driving a vehicle with a gallon of martinis inside you and a cherry on your head, go into politics, not cab driving. Because one conviction ever, and you're back in the bus queue. Now, the knowledge sounds impossible.
It isn't.
Otherwise, there'd be no such phenomenon as the London cabbie. It is true that no taxi driver in no other city, in no other country in the world, has to know a fraction of what you have to know. And not many brain surgeons either. But there we are. That's how we built an empire. And, no doubt, now we knock the bleeder down again. We live, we learn what we, in our ignorance, call knowledge. Now, the next
item... What the hell was I letting myself in for? I mean, I was only doing it for Janet, wasn't I? She'd got this mental attitude sort of thing. No job, no nothing, not even living together. I mean... the acrobatics fellas go through just to, you know, get their end away and that. Now that's knowledge. We live, we never bloody learn. Until then, the highlight of my day had been meeting Janet for her dinner break. Well, edited highlight really, she didn't get long. Home time, I'd do an action replay and meet her again. All morning with nothing to do but wait till 12:30 and all afternoon waiting for 5:30. It's like I was a baby still on the breast. Waiting for me next feed. All I had was Janet. It's all I wanted. She loved me and all.
Let me get out of the bloody gates.
The only place we could be on our own was her dad's garage. You see, I was banned from her mum and dad's flat, and she was banned from mine. Her old lady didn't want to get in serious with a dead leg on the dole, and mine thought she was only after me for me dole money. Then, one night, Janet's sister, Margaret Louise, caught us discussing the American involvement in Cambodia.
All right, Miss Bloody Piggy. What's it take to keep your mouth shut?
A skateboard.
There was one advertised second-hand in the evening paper, House Up Pentonville Way, which is how we came to wander in the Knowledge Boys' caf that day, and how I came to be here. Now, wishing I wasn't.
Now, take these back to the young lady at the appointments window. She will book your first appointment, which means your first test. So it isn't called an appointment. Come to that, it isn't called a test either. It's called an appearance. Funny old world we live in. Now that first appearance will be in 56 days' time, your next one 56 days after that, and so on. Eventually, if you're still with us. It will be every 28 days, finally every 14. How long it takes you before you get your license and your pretty green badge is up to you. And, no doubt, God. If you're a genius, it might take a year. On the other hand, it might take 2, or 7, or 10. If it looks as if it's taking longer than that, I should pack it in and have a go at ballet dancing. Any questions? In that case, thank you and good luck.
Mr. Weller.
You didn't quite tell the truth, did you?
I?
You're not averse, I noticed, to standing on your accelerator.
Sorry.
November 18, 1966, Brixton Road, 45 miles per hour.
1966? I wasn't even bloody born.
I told you we'd check. Watch it. Yes, Mr. Margolis?
I just wanted to say how... well, my father's a cabbie sort of thing, and his father before him, and the wife's like, and two of my brothers. And How, you know, well, being in the blood, really, I expect. I feel I'm already, well, not already. Anyway, they all wish to be remembered to you. Well, not my granddad, of course. And to pass on their very best wishes.
Mr. Margolis, passing the knowledge is different from everything else in the world. It's unique. It's not who you know, it's what you know. Know what I mean?
All organised then? Do we have lift off?
I think I'll pack it in.
Oh, nice. Nothing like starting off on the right foot, eh?
I'll never learn it all, Janet.
You haven't tried yet.
Can't do nothing, me.
Here we go again. Thanks. That's what a girl really likes to hear.
But what if it takes me 7 years?
What else have you got to do? Sorry.
I'll be past it.
Some blokes take a year, you said.
Yeah, I'm me, though, and I'm not other blokes. I never have been.
Chris, it's your first run. You're 468 to learn. They're not coming riding past you. Anyway, half my sodding bottom drawer's on this.
You're at work all day. Afterwards, the only chance we get for
well,
a
that's why you're doing it, ain't it, you Burke? The quicker you get the knowledge, the quicker we can have a quick everything. Now get lost and mind the roads.
Yeah, we'll get lost. All right, page one. List one. Manor House Station to Gibson Square. Now, where the old Manor House Station for a kickoff?
Well, what's your A to bloody Z for?
What a joke this is.
Yeah.
What?
Can't fancy coming with me, do you?
Chris, there's a great big world out there.
Oh, no.
Well, then.
Not that I didn't appreciate her reasoning, mind you. Lashing out her post office savings for me moped, me oil skins and that. It was like buying her own engagement ring in a way. It meant everything to Janet, the knowledge.
What knowledge?
I informed you what knowledge. Pity you missed it, darling. I've got a lovely speaking voice.
But what about your kitchen installing?
That's daytime, isn't it?
And what's this?
Evenings, isn't it?
Mine and all.
What?
What about my evenings? Out. Me wrestling. Me drag acts at the White Lion. Me mail order book. Me odd chicken in the bleeding basket. We like a ride out of a sodding evening.
Well, that's gone the way of all flesh and all. The Viva turned into a moped. 3 o'clock this afternoon.
Gordon, you...
Oi! This is me under this lot, not anybody. Gordon Weller. All right? Oh, hell.
What?
That's life, isn't it?
What is?
I only want a Jimmy Riddle, don't I? Take me half an hour to find it, let alone get it out.
I know the feeling.
Cheerio, love.
Typical. Off I go, starting the knowledge. Building a new life for us, and she can't even say cheerio. She had talked to her ornament on the mantelpiece, though. Oh, yes, her crinoline lady. She'd say cheerio to her crinoline lady if she was starting the knowledge. I'll knock her bloody head off one day. Crinoline ladies, I mean.
Leave on the left. Green lanes. Right Ivory New Park.
Hang on. What's the building on the left?
Islington Town Hall?
Well, if it is, some slimy bastard's moved it.
Thames Water Authority, Stoke Newington Pumping Station.
Thank you.
Right Ivory New Park. And left Ivory Grove. Right St Paul's Road.
Right, St Paul's Road.
You said that once.
Comply Ivory Corner.
Yeah, Comply Ivory Corner.
My head won't concentrate.
I have noticed.
Leave on left Green Lanes. On left, Thames Water Authority, Stoke Newington Pumping Station, Transport and General Workers Union Regional Office. Right, Ivory New Park. Left, Ivory Grove. Right, St Paul's Road. Comply One Way Working, Ivory Corner. Leave by Upper Street, Islington Town Hall on left. Right, Gibson Street. Set down on right, Gibson Square. Bingo.
Another chopped and fried.
I couldn't, honest.
For keeping your strength up. Brain food.
I've already had two.
For my being proud of you, doll.
I couldn't, doll.
Right, Ivory Park. Left, Ivory Grove. Left. No, right, no. Left, St Paul's Road. No, right. Comply, Ivory. What's it? Doodah. Corner. Comply, Ivory Corner.
Comply, Ivory Corner. Comply, Ivory. No, sod it.
What?
No, that's it.
It isn't.
Oh, it is for me. Yeah, I'm turning in. It is bloody impossible.
Other fellas do it.
Yeah, right, other fellas, right? They haven't.
Haven't got me.
Left Ivory Grove, right St Paul's Road, comply Ivory Corner, leave by Upper Street, right, Islington Town Hall, on your left, right Thurberton Street, then Gibson Square. I've done it.
See?
It's not that anyone goes from Manor House Station to Gibson Square.
But you remembered it.
First run. One down. Only another 467 to go. In a way, 467 to go is even worse than 468 to go. I'd have packed the whole thing in then and there if it hadn't been for Janet's boot up me backside. That and knowing I wasn't on me Todd. There's a lot of suffering in the world.
Every time, the minute I get on, must be a bloody gents here somewhere. It's psychological. I wish it was. Dressed different.
You need some assistance?
No, thanks.
Where do you wish to go to?
I don't. I'm not lost. I'm trying to sort out the one-way system across Oxford Street.
You want to go to Marks and Spencer?
What?
They're very good.
What?
You want the one near Oxford Circus or the one near Marble Arch?
I'm going to Grosvenor Square.
There is no Marks and Spencer in Grosvenor Square.
Leave on left, St John's Hill, forward Lavender Hill, old Battersea Town all on left. Cross Queenstown Road, forward Wandsworth Road, Polytechnic of the South Bank on left.
You're keen, ain't ya?
What?
What run are you on?
Well, what are you on?
Page 1, number 9, Clapham Junction, Lambeth Hospital.
Yeah, I am. Same here.
What, from down there?
Well, it's longer, that's all.
Well, if it's longer, I mean, why do you... I mean, you want Newington Butts, Dante Road at Brooks Drive.
You've got more than knowledge to learn, haven't you? Hey, darling.
Hey?
See ya.
What the hell was he up to? He was up to something. Where the hell was he going? He was bloody going somewhere. That wasn't paid. One run number 8, Clapham Junction to Lambeth Hospital. That wasn't Clapham Junction to anywhere. What did he mean, of more than the knowledge to learn?
Something. He left for work nearly 10 minutes ago.
I'm playing hard to get.
Did he mean what I thought he meant?
You're miles out of your way for Lambeth Hospital, darling.
Yeah, I think he did.
You're tired of living, are you?
Sorry, sir. Tired of living, he says. I'm waiting to start, mate. I'm still waiting to start. I told him. Couldn't answer that one.
King's Avenue to Montpelier Square, something like that. No traffic, nothing. I'll be home by 3.
And what'll the next run be? St Thomas Hospital for 6 months.
What?
You're gonna be ill, doll. You've got to be up 6:30.
All in the good cause, doll.
But you didn't come in till 11.
Yeah, well, I'll be loafing since then, haven't I?
Got a 3-year-old daughter. Never sees her father. One day she'll get married, please God. You'll walk down the aisle to give her away. She won't know who you are. Very nice.
Hi, aye.
Another lost soul in torment.
Yeah. Had your first appearance yet?
You what?
How you doing?
Oh, I haven't done 56 days yet, sir.
I thought not.
Well, pray you don't get the vampire when you have.
Who?
You might touch lucky. You might get Wilson. He's a gentleman, is Wilson.
Who's the vampire?
Or Mr. Makepeace. He's all right, as long as you know your runs. You won't get any aggro from Mr. Makepeace.
Who's the vampire?
Well, when he's a human being, he's called Mr. Burgess.
Oh, yeah, I know Mr. Burgess.
Nobody knows Mr. Burgess, pal.
What's he do to you?
Take a crucifix and a pointed stick, you'll be all right.
What?
Yeah, do you want a piece of advice, son?
Yeah, please.
Give it up and go back to ladies' hairdressing.
Well, you made it, didn't it? You got your green bleeding badge.
That's why I'm in a position to give you some advice, you schmuck. This game's finished.
Always has been.
You're better off on the dole.
Terrific. That's all I needed, wasn't it? Know what I mean?
Anyone sit me here? Sort of, you know, here and that. Help yourself. I met you, didn't I? At Margolis, Kingsbridge. That's it.
What's your handicap?
I'm Miss Walters, Kennington Oval. That's it.
Got a better memory than me, mate. I'll give you that free of charge. No one ever remembers my name.
Photographic, they say. Well, I say they. The wife does.
What? For a living or what?
What?
It's good trade, by all accounts. Seasonal, though, I think.
What is it?
Eh?
Oh, I see what you... No, I'm a Hoffman presser by trade in a laundry.
How do you mean?
No, it's all right.
The photographic's just an hobby then, is that it?
Yeah.
I enjoyed that discussion. Don't often get the chance of a good discussion. Swapping points of view, pros and cons and that.
No.
Cup of tea and a watch.
Bloody hell.
Is that the time?
Should be, 8 o'clock. The clock specialises in.
Yeah, I don't want the tea, sorry.
Appearance?
10:30.
Well?
What?
Well, it's only 20 past. You could bloody hop that in half a minute.
Yeah, well, still.
Poor sod. Bloody petrified, isn't he?
Who'd you have, mate?
Wilson on a 56.
What come up?
I'd only answer one, couldn't I? Liberty's the Swiss cottage, and I got that bastard wrong.
Cut up Regent Street, Portland Place.
BBC and all right, and Catherine Park.
Get some John Paul Turbis.
Yeah.
Oh, there is two.
Come in, all I said to her was Princess Margaret's looking a bit happier these days, isn't she?
Happier than who?
You are.
Spitalfields Market, Brecknock Road. All right. How about Spitalfields Market, Brecknock Road, then? Billingsgate Market to Newington Green. Fair enough. Spitalfields Market, Brecknock Road. Thank you, Mr. O'Reilly. Sensational. Next appearance, 56 days.
Says Mr. Weller next.
Needless to say, my luck. I don't get Mr. Wilson, the gentleman, I get the vampire.
Yeah, what was he like? The vampire.
Bleeding bloodsucker.
Howdy do. Pickfords.
Pardon?
Are you a furniture removal man by trade?
Eh?
Or a kleptomaniac?
Weller. G. Mr. Gordon Weller.
Where it was, please, the chair.
What chair? Oh, I see.
Thank you. Now sit on it. Well done. Now your first appearance, Mr. Weller.
Yes. Yeah, it is. Spot on. The very first. Quite correct.
What do you think about the American fraternity, Mr. Weller?
Pardon?
Americans.
You mean film stars?
What?
Which Americans?
From America.
What do I think of them?
What do you think of them?
Sean Connery's very good. Why?
I ask the questions, Mr. Weller. The Irish?
Sorry?
Now, don't have me repeating every syllable, Mr. Weller. I've had a long day ahead of me ever since I woke up, and it's getting longer.
and I've still to go to Sainsbury's on my way home.
What do you think of the Irish?
Well, Sean Connery's one, isn't it? Is it something I've said? I've come about the knowledge.
Standing outside St. Mary's Hospital, and I want to go to the Great Eastern Hotel. I'm standing outside St. Mary's Hospital, Trade Street, Edgware Road, and I want to go to the Great Eastern Hotel, Bishopsgate. And it's raining. I'm standing outside Arding and Hobbs, and I want to go to the London Fire Brigade headquarters.
To report a fire. In the bedding department.
Forward Lavender Hill, Wandsworth Road. Left, no, right. No, forward, no, right. Nine Elms Lane. Excuse me, you appear to have thrown your pencils on the floor, Mr. Burgess.
Never mind what I'm doing, Mr. Weller. Just concentrate on what you're doing.
Please don't let him be cocking it up. He's always cocked everything else up.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
How was it?
More goalies next.
How was it?
How do you feel about the Jewish fraternity?
What?
Oh, as you were. You're Mr. Margolis, aren't you? Right then. How do you feel about Manchester United football fans? Drunk.
Depends whether they're beating the Arsenal or not, really. So.
I'm at the northern approach of Tower Bridge. I want to go to BP House. Tower Bridge, which is at Tower Bridge. BP House, which, as you no doubt know, but prefer to keep secret, is in Carlisle Place.
Left Tower Hill, forward Byward Street, forward Lower Thames Street, forward Upper Thames Street, forward What's It Underpass.
Where?
Blackfriars Underpass.
What's It or Blackfriars?
Blackfriars.
Where?
Blackfriars Underpass.
Where? Where?
Blackfriars Underpass!
I'm not saying you're wrong. For all you know, I may be a little hard of hearing. Now, it's not very nice, is it? Losing your temper with unfortunate people who are hard of hearing, of which there are regrettably many thousands. Continue. You'll never make it, son. You'll never make a cabbie in 500 years.
This is my first appearance. I've learned 10 pages, 180 runs. I know them backwards. You say...
Not you. Him down there, taking his driving test. Not putting you off at all, am I, Mr. Margolis?
He'll be sat there getting 10 out of 10, bless him. The star pupil, top of the class.
Would you like me to repeat the question?
Yes. Please.
What was it?
Marry Lipman, Magistrates Court to Wilton Place.
Why do you want me to repeat it?
Don't know.
You don't know why, or you don't know the run?
I don't know.
Thank you, Mr. Walters. Next appearance, 56 days. See the young lady at the appointments window. Take your card. Go through the door. That's the door. With your legs. Those are your legs. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Very nice.
So I said to her, 32p, I said. Just like that. 32p was only 29 last week. And she turned round and said, well, chocolate's gone up. And I turned round and said, why? I said, just like that, why? And she said, well, the world price of cocoa's gone up. And I said, I don't want cocoa, I want a bar of bloody chocolate. I was a lady, though. I didn't swear. I don't want cocoa, miss, I said. I want a bar of chocolate. Yes, well, she said, chocolate's made out of cocoa. Oh, is it? I said, well, I'm not made out of money, and walked out. So, she didn't get no profit out of me. That showed her. Couldn't answer that. Of course, I didn't get no chocolate.
Which is Mr. Matthews?
Me.
You're on.
Come in.
Hello? Is that the appointments window? Yeah, this is a mate of Mr. Matthews. He was supposed to come for an appearance this morning, but... Well, what he's done, he's pulled his back out, shifting some RSJs, so he couldn't come this morning. So he was wondering if he could come another morning. Yeah, because like, he's very solid.
You believe in God?
Look, if you want to go, Barman, let's do it indoors, eh? We won't be back for another 20 minutes yet.
He must have one hell of a memory.
Who?
What's his name? God? It's not just streets of him. Thousands and thousands of houses, millions of people. And that's only London. There's everywhere else in the world as well, millions of places. Middlesbrough. It's out of credit, isn't it, eh?
Are you coming in or not? If not, I'm going to put my coat on.
Now, we had two Mormons come to the door once. They said, do you believe in God? My dad said, of course. I'm just not all that sure he believes in me. And that was before he turned nasty.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No, I don't.
And all this because you did a rotten appearance. He couldn't have been that horrible to you. What happened in there anyway? You went in
just bloody drop it, will you? I mean, give it a rest. I'm sick of the bloody knowledge.
It's not the end of the world, Chris. It's your first one. Another 56 days, it'll be different.
If a jacket in, you'll find somebody else. Eddie bloody hairstyle in your packing department.
And who says?
I say.
Well, you talk a load of cobblers, don't you? Where'd you learn your English? In a Chinese bloody takeaway?
You can't do the knowledge the way I'm doing it. It don't work. If you do it, you do it.
Heady hairstyle.
You do it full time, all the time. You do nothing else. There is nothing else.
It's the rest of bloody life, Chris. What's the knowledge? A few months ago, we'd never even heard of it. There's other things in the world, you know.
Is there?
There's us.
It's the same thing, isn't it? That's what I'm on about.
Page 8, run 12. Stock exchange to Euston Station. Run 13, Archway Road to Gresham Street. Run 14, Billingsgate Market to Newington Green. Run 15, Lothbury to Limehouse Police Station. Run 16, Bricklayers Arms Goods Station to St Martin's Theatre. It's a big place, London. It's so bloody big. You forget how small it is.
Give you one on Friday, right on then?
Cheeky blinder.
Be good. Oh, well, Kojak's with us again. Is my old lady paying you in bloody lollipops? Mind you, it's only Mondays and Thursdays I'm at it. The other nights I am on the knowledge. The finest alibi in the entire history of how's your father, this caper.
What about your missus?
Sorry? I don't understand the question.
Doesn't she mind?
Ignorance is bliss, Christopher. You know what I mean? My Brenda is highly blissful about the whole thing.
Oh, I see.
I'll take it you haven't fixed nothing up on the side then.
Me? Oh, I'm going steady.
I'm talking about on the side, you buck.
Well, I appreciate that.
Well, then.
I'm sort of engaged.
I'm sort of bloody married. Very happy at that, I might add. Too many people decry marriage these days. All it needs is a bit of give and take. Midnight yet, is it?
20 to 1.
You should be chuffed.
Should I?
I did two runs instead of one. Shattered I am. Get your head down, eh?
Oh, it's all right. I'm not, sleepy.
What do you mean?
Well, I haven't stayed up until 20 to 1 to do bloody callovers with you, have I?
If I just wasn't so shattered, I've been working my balls off.
I see.
What's wrong?
Golden. I don't care who she is or what you get up to together.
Oh, what?
What I do object to is if you're doing her when you should be doing the knowledge...
What the hell are you on about?
You'll never get your green badge. You'll always be a cowboy. And I'll always have tuppence in me bleeding purse.
I don't know what you're talking about. You've got a very suspicious mind, Brenda. Do you know that? You've hurt me now.
I am outside
the Fishmonger's Hall.
And I wish to go to
the Salvation Army at Cambria House.
What? I haven't all day, Mr. Matthews. If you carry on at this rate, I shall have to go by bus and we'll all be out of a job.
Leave by, left of, London Bridge, and forward, bare left King William Street, forward Lombard Street, forward Bank, left, by, Mansion House Street, forward Poultry, forward Cheapside, Newgate Street, St Paul's Tube Station on the left, St Paul's Tube Station on the left, forward Holborn Viaduct, forward Holborn Circus, Hatton Gardens on the right. Forward Holborn. Forward Holborn. Right into Great Graves Inn Road. Left into Guildford Street.
Something amusing you, Mr. Matthews.
What?
Pray continue, Mr. Matthews.
fair enough. I've done me duty. Passed the invitation on to her. A nice run out of a Sunday afternoon. Meet my new mates and their lady wives. And she doesn't want to know. Doesn't even answer.
I mean, special occasion. You'd think she'd talk for a special occasion. IT in Gunnersbury Park. How often has she had the chance of IT in Gunnersbury Park?
Well, sod her then.
She never speaks to me. I'll never speak to her. 18 years, I've had enough. My lips is sealed.
Where's he live then?
Commercial Street to City, West End, Kensington, on to Hammersmith.
Just what part of London? Wandsworth, Mayfair, Isle of Bloody Dogs. I don't need a running commentary on every lamppost.
Gunnersbury Park.
Thank you. It's like going steady with a bloody road map. Is it their own place or rented?
Dunno.
Have they got any kiddies?
Dunno.
Are they happy or what?
How do I know?
Don't you lot ever talk to each other?
Yeah, of course we do.
Well, what about it?
Sorry, you're wrong, mate. Forward Cromwell Road, right Warwick Road.
Right Marlowe's Road, Gordon. Then double back forward and right Cheniston Gardens. Left Wright's Lane, left High Street, Kensington.
Warwick Road, Holland Road. It's easier, isn't it, Chris?
Oh, yeah, straight road, isn't it?
He's right, you know, Ted. Then right Camden Hill Road, left Notting Hill Gate. Don't you see? I'm cutting corners.
Yeah, my way's bloody straight from A to B.
Well, my way's the real cabbie's way.
He's right, you know, Gordon. You just said I was right.
Yeah, well, you are, really.
No, I'm not.
No, not in that sense, no. Fair enough.
They're, fish, are they?
Yes. Well, it's company for me while he's out.
Here, I've got one for you. What happened to me last Monday? Laugh, I'll tell you. So 7 o'clock in the morning, I'm schlepping down East Tube, right?
7 o'clock?
I thought I'd get an hour in before I set off to work. I do most mornings. So there I am, King William Street, and I can see the traffic's jam solid on London Bridge. Traffic jam, 7 o'clock in the morning. It's never been known in the annals of Christendom.
You were doing East Tube?
East Tube to Oval Station. So I nips down Cannon Street, clocking the point, you know, Candlewick House on the left, Cannon Street Station, Bank of China, London Stone on the Mall, and suddenly the traffic's jam solid there and all. So this bloke in the car next to me lowers his window and says to me,
East Tube to where?
Oval Station. So this bloke...
Well, what run's that, then?
What?
He's cheap to Oval Station.
Pays bloody 15, knowing him.
Page 20. First one on page 20. So anyway, this bloke, chuckling away to himself there, says, well, that's made my day, that has, mate. And I says, what has? He says, well, didn't you see her? She ran right past you at the lights. Only a naked female, wasn't it? Stark nude. Jogging. Well, when I say stark nude, by all accounts, she had tennis shoes on. And that's why there was a traffic jam. 7 in the morning, right? Everyone jumping on their brakes, clocking an I-4s. I wonder there wasn't a 10-mile pile up. Now, the point is, there's Joe Soap here, and I didn't even notice her. All I bloody noticed was the Bank of China, the London Stone, St Andrews by the Wardrobe, and the Salvation Army HQ. You wouldn't credit it, would you?
I bet you would, though, wouldn't you?
You're on page 20, then?
Oh, no. That was a week or two ago. I'm on 25 now.
Do you ever feel you want to scream?
All day. I just haven't the energy.
I sometimes cry in the supermarket.
I haven't the energy.
What's wrong?
We're here. We're here and all, you know. What bleeding page are we on?
never hear a wrong word from my missus. Never.
Is that it, then?
What?
Well, I'm right for an hour or two. They won't be back till Max Bargrave's half eight.
Well, no. Well, it is. I think I'll get an early night.
Half eight? How early can you get?
Well, then I can start early in the morning.
I see. You enjoyed yourself in there, didn't you? With your mates? Lapped it up?
What do you mean?
Talking. I don't think I've heard you talk since the night I met you. All for Tiffany. Not to me, anyway.
What are you niggled about?
I'll see you lunchtime at work.
Half 12? I think I might be out Crittle Way half 12, 12-ish.
After work, then?
Well, I don't know, half 5-ish, I'll probably be...
When, then?
Well, I don't know, perhaps Wednesday?
Perhaps?
Oh, definite.
I always thought Tuesday came before Wednesday. Tuesday's been cancelled then, have they?
Hey?
Night, then.
You're niggled about something, aren't you?
It was round about then that I started getting these shooting pains in my shoulder. I went to the doctor. He said it was growing pains. Bloody balmy, I'd stopped growing years ago. Hadn't I? Anyway, I got a second opinion from Gordon. He reckoned it was a touch of lumbago from being on the moat bed in the rain during page 9. Bedford Square to Sussex Square. Porchester Square to Prince's Gate. Berkeley Street to Battersea Dog Zone. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Normal people can tell time's gone by from what's happening in the world. Like, Elvis Presley dies. Or the Ayatollah dude shouts the odds about something. Or Argentina win the World Cup. Things like that. Or from what's happening to yourself. Like, for instance, if a bird slips up with a bloke one night, well, she'll know when she has the nipper 9 months have passed, right? Now, with knowledge boys, it's different. They only tell time's gone by from clocking when roadworks start in Camden High Street to when they finish. Or a new roundabout in Fulham Palace Road or somewhere. Things like that. All knowledge boys know about Elvis dying is there was a show about him at the Astoria Theatre, Charing Cross Road. And what's the quickest way to get there from the Hilton Hotel?
Good luck, mate.
Yeah.
Good luck, mate.
Yeah.
Be lucky.
Did you put that in Belgrave Square?
Yeah.
Staying in this society, yeah.
Where'd you call it? Maltesers.
What?
Not Maltesers. Licorice all sorts.
What?
Licorice all sorts. Bassett's. Barrett's. Barrett's of Wimbole Street. That's it. Left Wimbole Street.
I beg your pardon.
Left Wimpole Street.
Licorice all sorts is Wimpole Street.
It's a word association. That's the way I remember it. To make it easier.
Easier.
To remember.
I was 18 numbers off winning a premium bond last week. 50,000 quid. I thought I'd blocked it from my mind. But I haven't.
Churches. He asked me about churches.
What'd you get?
Makepeace. Listen, I'll see you. Good luck.
Cheers.
He sits there asking me Westminster Cathedral to St. Paul's Cathedral like some kind of religious maniac. I sit there like a bloody Toby jug saying nothing. Next appearance, 56 days, as per bloody usual. If only he'd asked me Piccadilly Circus to Piccadilly Circus, do me a favour. How'd you get on?
Half three right, three wrong. Next appearance, 28 days again. That can't be bad. Should I have a cup of tea?
Why not? If you can't drown your sorrows, you might as well take them for a paddle.
Hey, Chris! Gordon! Hey!
He's done it!
Never. He has, he's got his sodding green badge.
Come on, let's see it in the flesh, in the flesh!
Oh! Made in Hong Kong. Forward Ping Pong Street, left Chop Suey Street, right What's-It Street. Prawn balls.
That's a minute, eh? It's still warm.
Well, somebody say Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov.
Thank you.
Well, I don't even know what it means.
Hey, sod the tea. Come on, they're open.
Who are?
What do you mean, who are? What's Jewish for champagne?
I don't drink.
You stand there, a little fellow with big earlobes, you pass the knowledge in 14 months...
13 3/4
And you're telling me you don't drink?
Listen, what do you want? I'm a Yiddish boy. Cards, yes. Women, certainly. Drinking, one small egg flip at Christmas, tops.
You got any money on you?
£3, but I need a...
Come on, hand it over. I've got 11. That's 14 quid's worth of champagne.
I don't drink!
It's Christmas, cabbie.
Ain't seen my mates, have you? Must still be doing their appearances, I expect. They said, you grab a table, we'll follow you on, have a cup of tea, bit of a chat. Half an hour ago, that was. More. Let's say forgotten. Would hardly do that, would they? Mates and that. They'd have noticed I'm not with them. Sometimes people don't notice when I am. I said, sometimes people don't notice me when I am.
Always a little wobbly on our bikes. Knowledge boys, it's traditional. I was a knowledge boy until 3 hours ago.
You ought to have more sense then, oughtn't you, sir?
That's where I got my green badge. Well, 2.5 hours, say. I'm cabby now.
You want a bet?
What do you mean?
Blow into this bag if you don't mind, sir.
Look, are you in love with him or something? I mean, just say the word, he can have all my brochures, dining room furniture, table lamps, music centre, the lot.
He started the same day I did, Janet. How do you feel if all my grafting was for nothing?
It might be yet.
Oh, thanks.
Well, he's not dead, is he, for God's sake? Fair enough, so he buggered up his knowledge. He's still got home, though, hasn't he? And a wife, and a kid, and a job.
Thanks again.
Look, I can't help the word job creeping up into the conversation every now and then. It's a word.
He's had it now, at this time next year. Carriage office won't review his case till then. He got it! He got his licence! He had his green badge in his hand! Oh, he's a genius at the knowledge, was Ted Margolis. No one will ever know.
You didn't look all that heartbroken at first.
What do you mean?
When you heard he'd been nicked.
I don't know what you're hinting. You mean I was chuffed or something?
Look, you're out with me now, all right? Once in a blue moon we're out together and that's now. We're not calling overruns, we're not listing points and we're not spending all night in the loo because you have an appearance tomorrow. We're doing other things, all right?
I was bloody choked when I heard...
All right, forget it!
It was me, mate.
Chris, I'm not going into mourning over Ted Margolis. So he's had it for another 12 months. He'll still be a cabbie before you will. It's only the knowledge, Chris.
What do you mean?
It's not real life, is it?
I don't understand what you're saying.
It's like a bloody illness with you, isn't it? A mental illness. Streets and streets and streets and squares and roundabouts to comply, names and names. And what are you at the end of it? A cabbie?
Well then!
What well then?
A cabbie! I'd be a cabbie!
That's right, Chris. Not a bank manager, you notice. Not a doctor or an architect or something. A bloody Tuppenny Ha'penny cabbie!
I don't know.
You never do know, do you, Mr. Weller?
I know one thing, Your Highness.
Now, be careful, Weller.
I know you've been getting up my nostril ever since the day I met you. As a consequence, any minute, Your Majesty, you're going to get my fist up yours.
I think it's safe to say that you are officially off the knowledge as from now. Goodbye, Mr. Weller.
I come here every 2 months. Yes, Sahib. No, Sahib. Who do you think you are? I'm a grown bloody man. At least I thought I was before I came into this torture chamber. Do you know something? I've shrunk 3 inches in height. Straight up, I've measured myself. I sit here like red rotten riding hood, scared to open my mouth, while you're shouting and bawling, needling, whispering, cracking on your deaf, scratching your backside. You don't want us to pass. You do everything you can to stop us. You're driving me bloody cocoa, mate. I used to be a smart fella. Birds used to give me the eye in Selfridges. Now I wake up in the middle of the night, my belly's shaking.
Mr. Weller.
One more poncy insult from you and you go on a chartered flight through that window.
Mr. Weller, has it ever crossed your mind? Why?
Why what?
There are two things a cabbie has to know. One is the knowledge, and the other is people. Because it's people who ride in cabs, and people are a very peculiar form of life. Compared with people, the knowledge is a piece of marzipan. They mumble, they can't hear you, they don't know where they want to go to. They get up both your nostrils. They treat you like rubbish. They spend their lives doing it to each other. In a cab, they do it to you. And I have to find out if that bothers you at all, because if it does, and you do it to them, you're no cabbie.
Well, I think you've got your answer, darling.
Shall I tear it up, will you?
I'll do that. That I can do. Merry Christmas.
Tell me something. Do they still call me the vampire?
The others do. I call you a part of the vampire's anatomy. A very small part.
Am I late?
Only 3/4 of an hour.
I was stuck on the North Circular.
You ain't been home to change yet.
But I've just said Anger Lane was solid.
Oh, well, it's been terrific standing here freezing to death.
All right, I said I'm sorry.
Did you?
Yeah, I bloody did.
Well, I wasn't bloody listening.
I suppose the pictures have started.
We could go for a drink.
I'm sick of tomato juice.
Well, you can forget me dad's garage. I ain't dressed for it.
Do you fancy a ride up the North Circular?
You've just been up the North Circular!
Right, there's a fair pubs up that way.
Chris, I ain't going out learning street names on our one night out.
It is not our one night out. We go out Saturdays. Sometimes.
We go to my dad's garage. You know all the streets from here to there. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Don't tell me you don't want to.
Yeah, of course I do.
Now what?
I ran out of petrol, haven't I?
Keep moving, Jan, if the air star's coming.
It'd take more than him.
See ya.
Not turned up then, has he? Fancy a lift home? Or somewhere? Jan, I've got my brother-in-law's van round the corner. Back seat folds down flat.
What makes you think I'd do?
Please yourself.
Here, hang about. I do wish you'd do something about your bloody hair.
He'd been right that very first day, old Burgess Vampire, at the acceptance interview. He'd said 7 out of 10 of us would never make it. So far, none of us had. 6 had jacked it in, and Ted, of course, was still disqualified. On top of that, he got sacked from the laundry for going to that last appearance without asking for time off, the one when he got his green badge. On top of that, his brothers and dad said Jewish prayers for the dead because he tried to get a job in a minicab office. Last I heard, him and Val had decided to sell up and emigrate to Israel.
Tom?
Yesterday was Wednesday, it was raining.
Etmol haya yom revi'i v'yaren geshem.
Today is Thursday, it is dry.
Hayom yom chamishi v'yavish.
Tomorrow it will be Friday. If it is sunny, we shall have a picnic.
Machar yihyeh yom shishi v'im yihyeh yom yefin asi picnic.
On the beach.
Alfad hayom.
The last time I saw Gordon, he was touting tickets to the queue for Evita, Prince Edward Theatre, Old Compton Street. I weren't in the queue, I was riding past, clocking points on a run. Anyway, seems he'd landed on his feet since he was kicked off the knowledge. He told me he'd now got a job with Lotus Cars as a test driver. Oh, and the other thing he told me was that he was totally faithful to his missus now. He'd stopped fixing himself up with spare crumpet on the side. It was all down to willpower, he said. Mind over matter. Well, that and an old Gunnersbury Park proverb. You'll never drop your pants if you never raise your hat. Of course, it weren't much fun for Janet them days. Me being, you know, out on the knowledge day and night. Still, she was very understanding. Didn't complain or nothing. Kept herself occupied and that.
Why not?
I don't want to.
Good night. Good riddance.
I didn't say I wouldn't. I said I didn't want to. Doesn't mean to say I won't.
No one's forcing you, darling.
I am. Darling.
Forward Westminster Bridge, left York Road, right Addington Street, left Westminster Bridge Road, forward St George's Circus, lead by Borough Road, forward Harper Road, left Swan Street, County Court on the left, I think.
Think or no?
No.
And you know what that run was, out of interest?
You asked me it. American Embassy at Southwark County Court.
Now, I'll tell you what it was, son. The last I'll be asking you.
What?
I'm giving you your rec, officially known as your requisition, officially meaning you've passed your knowledge of London. So now I put you down for a driving test. If you can get in some practice driving a cab beforehand, so much the better. Saves us having to drag the Thames for you in the middle of the rush hour. In the meantime, I should start swatting up your knowledge of the suburbs. There's only 60 odd of them. Got a list?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. I have so, yes, sir.
I don't detect a note of doubt, do I?
No, sir.
That was a joke. I tell jokes. I have a very comical nature. Right, your next appearance will be in 14 days' time. You should know most of the suburbs by then. It's child's play. Right, wheel the next one in. Jugular vein first. Oh, cheer up, laddie. You're past your knowledge. You're entitled to crack your face a little. What we in the carriage office refer to as happiness.
I think I'll pack it in.
Oh, nice. Nothing like starting off on the right foot, eh?
I'll never learn it all, Janet. Page one, list one. Man around station at Gibson Square.
Chris, there's a great big world out there.
It's bloody impossible.
Other fellas do it.
Yeah, right, other fellas.
I was just standing at the corner of the road observing. I saw your dog, Harold the footpath.
Did you?
Yes. Allow me to show my authority.
I'm sorry, we just bumped into one another on the street corner.
Yes. Well, I will point out where the dog has deposited.
With Eddie Airstyle.
Does it matter who it was with? It just happened to be Eddie.
I can't believe what you're saying.
Me neither. Yes, I can.
Yeah, I can too. It was you that bought me the moped in the first place.
And your shirt and tie for your appearances.
Yeah.
And half your sodding petrol.
I'll pay you back.
Just get your green badge and we'll call it straight, eh? You don't want me, Chris. You ain't for a long time. If ever. You just didn't know it, that's all. Same goes for me, really, with you. You know what comes into my mind when I'm sitting at work, bored out of my bloody skull? The little kid whose house we went to for the skateboard. Crying his little cross eyes out because we come for it. And his pig-ignorant father who was selling it. Belting him across the head because he was crying, so all he did was cry all the more.
We had some good times, though.
When?
It all ended one Wednesday, 1,042 days after it all started. 2 years, 10 months, 1 week, and 1 day. I got me inner London, me suburban, me driving test, me police identification, me references. And then, that last Wednesday, I was sent to the appointments window to get me green badge. Just like that. There was no fanfare of trumpets, no choir of angels, nothing. I went to the vampire's office to say goodbye, but I didn't go in. When I got to the door, I could hear a knowledge boy in there with him, crying.
Mr. Matthews? Your green badge. That'll be 15p. Thanks. Knowledge, is it?
That's right.
Got your birth certificate and driving licence?
Yeah, yeah.
That's your application form. You fill that in.
Right.
That's your medical form. Your doctor fills that in.
Right.
And that's your slip for the photographers in Upper Street for your photos. 6 copies.
Right, OK.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Next. Knowledge. Got your driving licence and birth certificate?
Manahan Station, driver.
Right, Governor. I'm picking someone up at Manahan. From there we want Gibson Square.
Manahan's to Gibson Square? You're joking!
Don't get awkward with me, son. I'll have your bloody number!
Ground. Football match.
What about it?
Well, how do we get there?
Your best bet is try saying please, mate.
You what?
Forward to the main road, right at first set of traffic lights, filter left by second on left, right Ailey Street. Forward Goodman Style into Commercial Road, the proof house of the City of London Gunmakers Company on right. The London College of Furniture on the left, Bishop of Stepney's house on right, forward East India Dock Road, Blackwall Tunnel approach on left, comply roundabout. Leave by Barking Road, left into Green Street, set down on right.
I go down to Main Road, and then I what?
The only other knowledge boy that started when I did and got his green badge was Titanic. The next day, he packed all his bits and pieces and left home, for good. According to him, his missus came to the door and spoke to him for the first time in 19 years, pleading for him to stay.
Piss off and don't come back!
I forgot to mention, there was another of our lot got a green badge. Not a knowledge boy.
Oi, leather arse, that was my job!
A knowledge girl.
Oh, hello.
See you, mate. Be lucky.
Oi, if you ever fancy a cup of coffee or something.
Like I said, we live, we never bloody learn.
And streets to place. Do yourself a favour. Say goodbye to the human race when you're a taxi driver. London Fire Brigade HQ, left where Vauxhall Bridge is. Right up Fitzjohn's Avenue, left where Selfridges is.
That's the knowledge badge of green. That's the knowledge.
Not on Main. Bear left at the London Zoo. Bear right Crystal Palace. Bear left him back bloody too. But never bear no malice. Passport office, petty France. Greenwich for the cutty sock. Hammersmith Palais de Danse. Clock the mosque in Regent's Park.
That's the knowledge, badge of green. That's the knowledge.
Know what I mean? From Wimbledon to Lambeth Pier, it's all part and parcel. Round and round till you disappear up your elephant and castle. Wormwood Scrubs is Upton Way, where villains do their porridge. Grateful their judge didn't say they'd have to do the knowledge.
That's the knowledge, badge of green. That's the knowledge.
Know what I mean?
That's the knowledge, badge of green. That's the knowledge.
Know what I mean? That's what I mean.
That's the knowledge.
God save the Queen.